using MLRS Research Map for surface mining activities. MLRS Overview.
Hi, this is Megan with the Bureau of Land Management Application Support Section, here to talk to you about how you can use the Mineral and Land Record System to perform research about activities on public lands. I'm here at the BLM.gov homepage, where I've went to Services and Land Records to get to this informational page about MLRS. MLRS is the application that we use to record our land and mineral records, which includes things like designations, mining claims, land use authorizations, community pits, and others. On this page are a lot of informational resources, including quick links to MLRS-related reports, program information, brochures about the publication of and implementation of MLRS, and a link to the MLRS application itself. The button titled Click Here to Access MLRS will take you to the public portal and the MLRS website. MLRS does have a public portal, which you are welcome to use. You can either register and log in, and we call that an authenticated user, or any member of the public can use it without logging in, although logging in does have added benefits.
Using the MLRS Research Map tool for surface mining activities.
In today's video, we're going to demonstrate how to use the MLRS Research Map to perform a spatial search about a particular activity on public lands. This demo will focus on plans and notices. I'm at the virtual public room, or MLRS community, and I'm going to access the research map by pushing this research button at the top header panel. The MLRS research map can take a moment to load all of the layers. Take notice of the buttons here. In the top left are buttons to zoom in and out on the map, as well as our standard map disclaimer. In the top right is the search bar for a map, followed by an informational icon below, which we'll talk about in greater detail. And in the bottom right are icons to print, to view the legend, to adjust layers, and to select a specific base map. Let's begin by zooming into a specific location using the search functionality. In the search bar, I'm going to type the area I would like to go to. I have entered Joshua Tree National Park. You can see I did not enter a state value or anything more specific. I'm going to hit enter on my keyboard. I can hit the search bar right here, or if you give the system a little bit of time, it's going to help try to populate values for you. I'm going to proceed by just hitting enter on my keyboard. The research map is then going to zoom me in to that location. You can see it zoomed me in quite extensively. I can use this negative button here to zoom out on the map. Or if I have a scroll wheel on my mouse, I can always roll it to zoom in and out. Now, what we see on the map isn't wholly useful at this time. So now it's time to make some adjustments using the buttons in the bottom right to make the map work better for us. I'm going to begin by using the bottom button to select a base map. In this demo, I'm going to select the topographic map. It's looking a little bit better, helping me identify where I am. Now I'm going to go into the layers list. It's important to know what layers by default are on in the MLRS research map. By default, only the BLM administrative units, the BLM Public Land Survey System, or PLSS, and state and local admin units are turned on by default. There are many sublayers and layers in the MLRS research map. You can see a lot of these top selections are certain BLM program areas that have cases associated with them. And then we also have more administrative layers. To make the map work better for me, I'm going to start by turning off the public land survey system layer. You can adjust a layer just by selecting or unselecting the checkbox for the master layer. What's also important to note is within any of these case type layers, by default, all of the active or authorized cases are turned on. Other case dispositions or case statuses are not on, so you may need to adjust specific sublayers. With regard to plans and notices specifically, it's important to know that they exist within the solid minerals case group. And within solid minerals, they are specifically categorized in a case group called locatables. So I'm going to use this little arrow to the left of solid minerals to expand this to see the case group layers within the solid minerals master layer. You can see it's broken down by BLM case groups or sub case types if you want to think of them. There's coal, there's non-energy leasables, locatables, saleables, and oil shale. We are going to be specifically interested in these locatable layers, but as I said, by default, all of the active or authorized layers within these case group layers are turned on by default. So if I turn on the master layer, you'll see I'll start to get some color on the map. It did take a moment to populate, and I did pan my map a little to find the area I wanted. But you can see now that I turned on the solid minerals master layer, I now have some colored and hashed shading on the map. In the scenario that I'm interested only in plans and notice activities, I need to remember that by default, this is showing all authorized solid minerals cases in all of these case groups. So one of the first adjustments I want to make is to turn off the case groups that I'm not interested in. The layers showing the authorized cases are with any of the case groups that are followed by case disposition. So I am going to go through these sublayers. And again, if you don't see them, your master layer may be minimized like so. You just click this arrow to expand it. And once again, I'm going to click the arrow to expand the sublayer. I'm going to turn off all of the case groups that I am not interested in. I can skip any that do not end in case disposition. Locatables are the area that plans and notices live in. So I'm going to come back to the locatables layers in just a moment. I'm going to proceed by turning off the rest of the subgroups. There's nothing wrong with leaving all of the layers expanded as you go. I'm just minimizing them to save space. And you saw my map adjusted as I was turning off some of those layers. The blue hash that was in this area is now gone, but we still have some remaining features on the map. I'm going to return to the two locatable layers. And in this scenario, let's pretend I want to see not only authorized plans and notices, but I also want to see pending. So I'm going to turn on this additional sublayer. And I'm going to visit to this next subgroup, which actually breaks it down by even more specific case types or case groups. So here you see they have specific layers just for plans and just for notices. As I'm in these layers, a nice tip is if you go over to the right from any of the labels, there's this thing that looks like a bulleted list icon. That's actually a mini legend or key. So if I click that, I can see that plans are generally shaded a brown color and notices are more of an orange color. Similarly, I could do it for the case disposition hatched shading and see the different symbology for those. Now I can see some features in my map, but what if I want to know more? Don't forget that there are other layers available. For instance, you may want to know who has the surface management authority on the lands where some of these cases exist. If you scroll down on the layers list, there is a layer for surface management agency. I'm going to check that box to turn it on. And now you can see my map has a little bit of color, although it's quite faint. If you would like to make the visibility a little better, at the three dots to the side are some more options. You can see there's an option here to increase the opacity. Now I click that about five times to make my surface management really defined. I could make any other layer adjustments that I needed. Say if I wanted a quick view of what township and range some of these were in, I could turn back on the public land survey system. I'm going to leave it off now just for this demonstration. I'm going to close my layers list at this time so I have more real estate to work with on the map. Let's say I'm interested in this particular case right here. I'm going to zoom in on my map a little bit. And we do have some information based on our shading and the polygons now. We can tell whether it's a plan or a notice. We can tell whether it's authorized or closed or pending. But I'm not so great at remembering all that symbology. So this information icon is a great tool to find out more about these specific projects. If you click the information icon, then click in the area you are interested in, you're going to get an informational pop-up in the bottom left of your map. You can see it took me right to that plan. The polygon is highlighted, so I know that's what's selected right now. But it's important to note that this informational table here will show a brief review of any layer that is turned on and intersects where you click. So down here in the bottom right of this little table, you can see this is one of six results. I can either page through these, or if you click in the middle, you can see all of the layers that you have turned on that were intersected. So I have both of my, what type of case it is, and I have that case disposition layer like we had in the layers list. I also have some of our administrative layers. You can always page through these if you prefer. And you can see now that I'm off the case record, the shading is gone from my polygon. As I return, some important features here. I have a serial number in case I want to investigate further, or I want to use this in a report, say to pull a serial register page or to cross-reference for anything. I have the type of case it is, the status it's in, and the amount of case acres.
Viewing detailed information in MLRS and the National Reporting System.
Let's continue with our informational table. Although it has great basic information, you may want more information about this specific case or project. Down at the bottom are a couple of links that may work great to gain that information. The first is a link to the case in the MLRS community. If I click that link, it's going to open me up a new tab, which looks at this case specifically. It starts on this details page, which has some header information regarding the case. Basic details. There are many other areas of information here, including land records, which show the legal description, related records, which contain the case actions. The BLM records case actions for every major activity on the case. Case transactions would reflect any monetary payments received since the implementation of MLRS, and case customers will show the holder of the case. An important distinguishment to make here is that due to Privacy Act requirements, this section would be blank if this were an individual. Individual information is not available to an unauthenticated user. You must be logged in. So while anybody can see when a company or a business is a case customer on a BLM record, an individual would only show if you were logged in. Otherwise, this section would be blank. Since the case link that we used from the MLRS research map opens in a separate browser tab, we can easily return to our research map for further investigation or modification. Let's talk about this serial register link now. This serial register page link should essentially redirect you to the MLRS reporting dashboard from our National Applications Reporting System, insert the specific serial number for the case, and run the report for you, resulting in a preview of the serial register page for that case. A serial register page is like a case abstract. It has all the major information about the case consolidated into one document. From the serial register page preview, you can elect to print the SRP. You can open it in a viewable PDF, or with the gear icon, you can select options for exporting the SRP for your use and review.
Using MLRS Research Map for surface mining activities as an authenticated user.
As you saw in the demonstration so far, MLRS can be a great tool to get the information you need. The research map provides a great spatial depiction of cases on the ground, and there are other tools linked in MLRS as well to get additional information about specific cases. Let's talk about some added benefits you can have if you elect to register and log in to MLRS. You can tell I have went to the MLRS research map again at the top, but I am now logged in. Instead of seeing a logged in button here at the top, you see a little profile icon. I also have some additional selections up here, as well as some additional buttons on the map. Here are my preferences icon, a bookmarks button, and my previously saved bookmarks via this little drop down arrow. In addition, on the right side, there are some additional buttons available now to upload your GIS files or to add features to the map. Let's return to the bookmark selection via this drop down arrow and look at a previously saved bookmark that I have. Here you see I have the Joshua Tree area that we visited before. By using saved bookmarks, you can quickly navigate back to locations, and the map will save your layer selections that you have on. Again, let's go to another location. And again, my map will always have whatever layer selections I have already made saved in my map. I can modify them at any time. Next, let me show you how you might want to save another bookmark. So let's go to another location. I typed in Shakespeare, New Mexico. I'm going to hit enter on my keyboard to zoom me to that location. Once again, I still have my plans and notices layer selected. And if I want to visit this location again in the future, scan these features to make them a little more central. I'm going to click this bookmark icon flag here on the top left. That's going to open up the window of my existing bookmarks where I can give it a new name. And I can save that selection via this plus button. I could also delete any of my old bookmarks that I'd like. Can just close this out, and now I have that available in my list. If you routinely look at the same locations in one of your activities, this can be a great way to save time. I also want to point out that if you ever need additional assistance, you can visit our Help Center by clicking Help Center in the top navigation area next to where we clicked Research for the research map and by the search bar. The Help Center has many articles available on how to use MLRS. You can also navigate there directly by going to mlrs.blm.gov/help-center. In addition, you can always search common terms in the global search bar here at the top. For instance, I typed in how to use the map, and I search, and once again, it's going to provide a system-wide search with certain categories of results here on the side. You can default by clicking on knowledge, or you can see knowledge articles are here at the top, and I could always hit view more to find resources. In addition, on the MLRS Help Center page, if you scroll down, there is a link where you can submit a ticket to our public help desk, or you can go to that page manually by going to www.phd.blm.gov. Should you need additional assistance. On the Public Help Desk site, under Application Heading, select Mineral and Land Record System from the pull-down. Fill in the description box with the particular item you are having difficulty with or the support item that you need. Following, fill out your name, email address, and phone number, and then click the Save button and your ticket is submitted. We will then respond to your issue. I hope this demo on how to use the MLRS site, particularly for finding surface management uses on public land, has been helpful, and I appreciate your time for watching. Thank you.
Make an account today and discover the future of mining claims with the Mineral and Land Records System at mlrs.blm.gov.